Hi, I'm singer, saxophonist, songwriter Curtis Stigers, and you're watching Lifeminute TV.
Award-winning singer, songwriter, saxophonist Curtis Stigers first stepped onto the scene in 1991 with his eponymous debut album that sold 1.5 million copies. Since, Stigers has gone on to tour the world, opening for the likes of Elton John, Prince, Eric Clapton, James Brown, Joe Cocker, Rod Stewart, and Bonnie Raitt, to name a few. His latest album, This Life, is a celebration of 3 decades of his professional music journey. The album reflects on his 13 albums, thousands of concert performances, and millions of miles on the road. We took a look back at his long and impressive career, which includes playing for presidents and princes. The talented Boise-born artist even serenaded us with his guitar.
Love is a hunger. It burns in my soul. This Life is a look back at 30 years in the record business, 30 years on the road, millions of miles and thousands of concerts. I wanted to show how much my songs and the arrangements of my songs have evolved, like I have. We've created new arrangements for them, my band and I. I used to play with a pop soul band, and now I play with a jazz quintet. So we do versions of my old songs that are entirely different. I recorded What's So Funny About Peace, Love, and Understanding for the soundtrack to The Bodyguard. And we now do a completely different version of that, and I wanted to show that. I also sang and co-wrote the theme song to the Sons of Anarchy, the TV show. And we do a very different version from the version that was recorded for the show. The Bodyguard soundtrack was so huge, and it was such a surprise. I recorded a song by one of my heroes, Nick Lowe. He wrote the song. Elvis Costello sort of had the famous version of it, of What's So Funny About Peace, Love, and Understanding. But then the movie came out and the album started selling. And because of Whitney Houston's 5 hit songs, massive hit songs, the album sold 45 million copies. And then the Sons of Anarchy thing, that was just a really nice break. A friend of mine was the music supervisor, and he asked me to write the lyrics. Once I'd written the lyrics or co-written the lyrics, I sang a demo for it, and that demo became the recording. So I was the voice of Sons of Anarchy. It led me to, or led a lot of new fans to me. We were nominated for an Emmy Award. That was cool. I got to go to the Emmys and ride in a limo with my friend Seth MacFarlane. He's a movie star. But Seth is a great singer, and we sang on a couple of big orchestral shows at Royal Albert Hall and became friends. We toured a little bit after that with that orchestra. And I was actually in Boston while he was shooting that first Ted movie to sing with him. We were recording the album of this concert that we had done in London, and he said, well, why don't you just stay an extra day, be in the movie? Okay, sure. So I pretended to play piano. I don't even play piano. And then I'm not in the movie after that. The second movie he asked me to be in, and I get to sing at Ted's wedding, at the teddy bear's wedding at the very beginning. I'm actually the wedding singer. So I do actually make a real appearance where I make some noise. But it's a very funny thing to have people say, were you in Ted? Well, I got to write several songs with Carole King, one of which was on my album Brighter Days many years ago. Carole is an old friend, and what an amazing writer. I was so lucky to work with her. So I've written with a lot of cool people. Barry Mann, who wrote You've Lost That Love and Feeling, with his wife, Cynthia Weil. I duetted with Al Green. I duetted with Sean Colvin. These are people that I idolize. I played at Buckingham Palace recently, actually, just a couple of years ago. I got to play with the Ronnie Scott's big band for Prince Charles and the whole Prince's Trust. They were all there gathering for a week, and I was the special guest that night. I got to sing some songs, sing one of my songs and a couple Sinatra things. He was very, very nice. I was very impressed with how down to earth he was. He met every single member of the band. He shook the hand of every member of the big band. It was 20 guys. Asked them what instrument they played. He was a lot hipper than I thought he'd be. He was like a really good cocktail host, you know, a good cocktail party host. He's like, hey, hello, welcome to my house. Van Morrison has been coming to my shows in London the last couple of times I played there. That's almost debilitating to have Van Morrison in the audience. To have grown up listening to someone as much as I did, and then to have him in the audience, it's a little terrifying. I am back out on the road. I'll be all over the world. You just check out curtisstigers.com and you'll see I'm a busy man.
To hear more of this interview, visit our podcast, Life Minute TV, on iTunes and all streaming podcast platforms. And don't forget to subscribe to our podcast, Life Minute TV. Searching for love.